The following program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.
Welcome to another episode of Gate City Chronicles. Today I have a very special guest, and we're going to be talking about my favorite topic, and that has to do with music. And to talk about music, I have Tori
Caruso
from the Nashville Community School of Music.
Yes, the Nashville Community Music School.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much.
Glad to have you.
I'm glad to be here.
So, let's talk.
Great.
What's going on with the school this year?
Well, we're just wrapping up our summer program. So during the summer, our lessons kind of take a back seat to our camps. We have quite a few music camps that we run, and we're just wrapping those up. And actually, as of right now, fall registration is open for our fall term. So we're kind of ending summer and then beginning into the new school year with more lessons and more programs.
So where are the camps? Where do you hold the camps?
Right in the school.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what is a typical camp look like?
Well, we have camps about different topics. We range in ages from really young. So we do, the camp that's coming up this week is called Instrument Safari, and it's geared towards the young children who are interested in lessons but don't really know what they like to play.
Right.
It's an opportunity for them to try all sorts of instruments, to actually get to put their hands on it and try it, like a trombone, they'll get to blow into it, or piano, they'll get to try and play, and then use that to kind of help them decide what to play or take a lesson in. And we have other camps about composition and camps about pop music and camps geared towards drumming.
What's composition?
Composition, like songwriting. So it's learning to write a song, and it's in different ways. So it could either be writing like a score, learning how to write a score of music, learning how to play a little bit of piano so you can write down what you're playing on piano. So it's kind of music theory and being creative all wrapped into one.
Wow, that's interesting.
Yeah.
And what are the age levels that go to these camps?
It's all ages. So it's from 6 or even 5 until 13, I think, or 14. It's like young elementary to older elementary.
What's the earliest you think somebody should introduce an instrument to a child?
I'm biased. I think it should be as early as they could be interested in it. My dad plays piano, and I have two brothers, and he made us all sit down at a piano when we were 5 years old. And he made us take piano lessons with him for a year, and then when we were 6, we could decide if we didn't want to take them anymore. So I started real early, so I feel like as early as you want to, you could start. Music can reach all ages.
Now, I forgot to introduce you as the newly elected or newly appointed assistant director.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Yeah. I've been teaching voice lessons and doing music therapy at the school for 3 years. And I'm super excited to be in this new position.
So we really need to get something out of the way. You're not related to the Caruso.
I am not. No. Okay. No, I am not. I have been told that I should tell people that I am, but I absolutely am not. I'm not going to lie.
And you teach voice.
Yes, I do.
Right.
Yeah.
You're the one who said, oh, now you got to breathe from your diaphragm.
Yes.
And you got to stretch your jaw.
Precisely, yes.
Oh,
yes.
Look straight and, okay.
Posture, everything.
Yeah. Yes, posture is everything. Right. I tried that. I didn't do too well with that.
Yeah.
There was a teacher in Hudson or Pelham, Pilecki was his name, Mr. Pilecki. I don't know if he's still around, but it was a long time ago. And I didn't do what he told me.
Oh, no.
It's hard to teach me. School starting.
Yes.
Okay, so what's happening this fall? What type of, any new courses?
So there are our typical lessons of all sorts of instruments, and then we're starting up some fall programs in September. We have our Trash Talk Ensemble, which is a really popular ensemble at the school. It runs every year. It's kind of our version of recycled percussion. And then we have an...
Trash Talk.
Yes, Trash Talk. Okay.
And that's music.
It's music. Okay. So they play on garbage cans and garbage lids and buckets and kind of create music in a creative, different way.
And that's and they have a good time with that.
They do. They love it. And they get a lot of opportunities to perform. They're a really sought after group. We perform every year at the Holiday Stroll in Nashua with Trash Talk. And they're...
I think I've seen them. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. All right. Wow. Yeah,
they're very loud. They're hard to miss.
Yeah. Yeah. But it's interesting.
Yeah.
To say the least. So, okay. Trash Talk.
Yeah. So Trash Talk, we're doing an intro to piano course geared towards younger kids who may be a little too young for a one-on-one lesson, to focus for a one-on-one lesson, but could benefit from a group course. We also are doing an intro to singing course geared toward for ages 6 to 9. And the theme of the course is R&B, soul, and funk, I think. It's R&B and soul, and that's geared for the little kids, so I feel like that could be a really fun...
So are we talking 70s R&B, or...?
I think it's going to span the decades.
Okay. I'm very biased towards the 70s R&B.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Aretha and all them.
Oh, yeah. Amazing. I mean, it's... How can you not be?
Yeah.
They're so good.
So, interesting. A real quick question. If somebody wants to go to the school, do they have to have an instrument?
No. We are lucky to be able to provide instruments for people who need them. Mm-hmm. We have pianos in all of our studios at the school. I think it is recommended to have a keyboard available to you if you're going to be a piano student or a voice student. But other instruments like the wind instruments, we're able to provide that for the students.
I was going to ask a really dumb question with regards to keyboard and piano. Are there different techniques, or obviously the same keys, but somebody says, oh, I play keyboard, I don't play piano. What's that mean? I've heard people say that. To me, it's the same instrument.
I think I kind of regard them in the same way.
Yeah.
I think maybe it might be different styles of playing. So keyboard is more associated with like pop music and more contemporary music, where piano is more associated with classical.
Okay.
So maybe that could be what they mean. But I think the technique is similar for both.
So has the school grown?
It has. We, I think the beginning of last year, we opened a new wing of the school. So we were able to expand to a part of the building right next door to us. We have a dedicated drum studio, which the teachers really love. And we have a piano classroom in there. So it's growing in a really great way.
Now, for people who don't know where the school is, where is it?
It is at 5 Pine Street Extension. So it's in the Mills part of Nashua. It's kind of hard to find, but we have a lot of signs up. It's near like Banyan Tree Yoga.
I know Bikram Yoga is there.
Yeah.
Now it's called Honey Sweet or Hot and Sweet.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, they changed the name. But that's in that little area right there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And so basically, if you were to look at that big smokestack, turn a left in there. Is that correct? Or turn right, depending on
your direction.
Depending on which way you go.
Yeah, if you're coming from Hannaford, you turn right. If you're coming the opposite way, you turn left.
So if you know where the light school, the light store is, it's right around that area.
Yes, it's right across the street.
Yeah, okay. And is first floor, second floor?
Or second floor.
Second floor. Mm-hmm. All right. And registration starts?
Open today.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, right now. You could go to the website and register right now.
And is there a point where it gets... too full, or?
There are definitely times where teachers might have a waiting list, but we have multiple teachers for multiple instruments, so we try to accommodate students as soon as they are interested. And the school is growing, and it's always hiring new teachers and looking for new teachers. So the chance of a wait are small, but there is a chance that there could be a wait.
So you said that you were a voice therapist?
I'm a music therapist.
I'm a
board certified music therapist.
What is that?
So what music, I'm so glad you asked. Music therapy is using music as a tool to work on non-musical goals. So if you're familiar with like physical therapy or occupational therapy, we kind of work in tandem with those therapies, using music as a tool to work on goals you'd see in those types of therapies.
Explain a little more.
Sure, sure. So I work mainly right now with children on the autism spectrum. And so I don't go into a classroom and teach them how to play piano or how to play guitar. I use my guitar and my voice to work on goals that are not related to music, like saying hello or maintaining eye contact, social goals, emotional goals. I have some physical goals that we're working on, like gross motor, fine motor skills. Music is also used in the older adult population, adults with dementia and Alzheimer's, to kind of improve their quality of life. Right.
Yeah, it's funny how that if you have dementia or Alzheimer's, that sometimes the music can bring back good memories.
Yes.
And same way with smell, from what I understand.
Yeah, smell is also very powerful.
Yeah, I know when we were up at the Capitol, on occasion you would see children come into the Senate chambers with headphones on because they were very sensitive to music. And I know in the beginning, some of the times the teachers were a little concerned because we were going to sing.
Yeah.
And those kids, they came out of their shell or something, and they were smiling when they normally didn't smile. It's amazing what music can do.
Yeah, it's really powerful tool.
It really can open up things.
Definitely.
Yeah. So great, and so it you can start now. Our class is starting now too?
So our groups start in September.
Okay.
The registration for the groups isn't open just yet, just for our private lessons. And music therapy is also open. You can register and contact the school for a consultation.
How do people get in touch with, how do people even know about music therapy?
Well, I think that it's becoming more popular. It still is something that I get asked about all the time. What is music therapy? What is it that you do? I think that a really powerful advocate for music therapy has been Gabby Giffords.
Okay.
If you're familiar with her story, she used music therapy in her recovery to regain her speech.
I heard of a guy named Michael Terrell. I don't know if you ever heard of him.
He
uses whole tones.
Okay.
For healing purposes. Mm-hmm. And you hear 27 minutes of just whole tones.
Yeah.
And it's supposed to be calming or something like that, or for sleep. I've heard it for sleep.
Yes.
Actually, I use it for sleep.
Mm-hmm.
But
so that's different from music therapy.
Okay.
I have some people I know who are called sound healers, and I think that might be
what
you're referring
to. Yeah.
Yeah. So for music therapy, you have to go to an accredited university. You have to get 4 years. You get a bachelor's degree. And then you have to do, I don't remember how many hours, so many hours of an internship. And at the end of that time, you take a board certification exam. And then you're a board certified music therapist and able to work in most states, except for a few who require like a expressive arts therapy degree.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So tell me about some of the successes.
At the school?
Yeah.
So we, in regards to music therapy or just in general?
In general or both.
Okay. So I feel like our music therapy program, our biggest success has really been its growth, I feel like. It started out really small.
Mm-hmm.
I started working at the school 3 years ago, and I had a slew of voice students and one music therapy client. And now our clients have grown in numbers, and we are offering group services as well at the school. And I think that's been a really huge success for the music therapy program. I think that the school's been successful in being able to serve all members of the community. So we're really doing programming that is accessible to children of all ages, to adults, to older adults, and to members of the community with disabilities, with special needs.
How would somebody know to ask for music therapy?
So they might read about it and want to know more. They might have done it in the past. It also could be that they have a child, or they themselves have responded to music really well in the past, and they want to see kind of what it's all about. It is one of those things where I think it's hard to know exactly what it is without doing it or seeing it done.
That's what I mean. So how would somebody know? Well, we're not gaining any ground with communication.
Mm-hmm.
So Is this an area why I would consider music therapy? Is because of the communication?
Definitely, definitely. Okay. I've used music for communication goals, whether it's verbal communication or just communication simply as like maintaining eye contact, things like that. And so we would take that kind of goal and we would build a treatment plan around that goal. We would write songs specifically tailored to those needs. We would also use preferred music. Preferred music is huge, especially with little ones and really all ages, but I specifically am thinking of a little one who loves like Old MacDonald. I feel like if you sing to a little one and you go, Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I, they're gonna go, oh, immediately. And it could be someone who's verbal, it could be someone who's nonverbal. They know that oh is like in there, in them.
Give it to me.
Yeah, they're say like, it, I want it, it, I want it, I need it. So right. They're gonna say it because you're not saying it. Mm-hmm. So music is a really, it really builds anticipation in a way that like regular speech doesn't. And that's really helpful for improving communication.
So when you sit down with somebody who's for the very first time, they might have an autistic child that's, mm-hmm. you know, 3-4 years old, and it, you know, it's pretty clear that maybe that's what the issue is, and you want to develop these skills. What's your first approach?
My personal approach, there are so many ways you could go about doing music therapy. Personally, I come at it from a very person-centered way of things. Mm-hmm. I take what I'm being given from the client. So if I go into a room and a child is feeling really shy and they're kind of sitting in one corner and they're turning their back to me, I might like play music really quietly to kind of like echo their movements and kind of like perk their ear up a little bit and be like, oh, what's she doing? But if I have a client that's really loud and boisterous and energized, I will play really loud, energetic music and kind of go from there and see what they can give me initially, mm-hmm. and then build on what they're already bringing to the session.
Oh, okay. So yeah. It's definitely individualized, obviously.
Yes, definitely. It's different for everybody. It doesn't look the same. And every therapist is different. So the way that I go about doing something is not necessarily the way that another therapist would
do it. And you like doing it.
I love it. I absolutely love it. I feel so lucky that it's my job. I feel like it's
very, not work.
Yeah, it's not work. It really isn't. And I'm so happy that as the assistant director, I get to continue doing music therapy at the school. It's something I'm really passionate about continuing. And hopefully the program will grow where I won't be the only music therapist there and we'll have many music therapists and maybe some student therapists. And I feel like the sky's the limit for the program.
So what's the instrument of the year? What's being what are kids being more attracted to these days?
Well, I feel like voice is always popular. Mm-hmm. We are always looking for voice teachers. piano is definitely a big one. Drums are very popular. Kind of your typical, like your rhythm section instruments or guitar. Yeah, those are our big ones.
So do you ever watch The Voice?
I do. I do watch The Voice. It's the only voice competition that I will watch because I like it.
Do you cringe sometimes?
Sometimes.
Sometimes, yeah. When they get a little pitchy and stuff. Yeah. But then sometimes you go, oh my gosh, that's a great voice.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I like the voice. Where'd that come from?
I know, I like The Voice because I feel like it's less cringe moments and more just like really great singers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I tried out for it.
You tried out for The Voice?
I did try out for
it. My goodness.
Yeah.
How'd it go?
Well, I didn't get a yes and I didn't get a no. So I'm just thinking they just lost my number.
Oh no.
It was fun though. It was a really fun day with my wife.
Yeah. We've actually had some students from the music school try out for The Voice.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's been a really wonderful learning experience for them.
There's thousands of people.
Yeah. There's so many.
And the attitude is so wonderful in there.
Oh.
We went to the one in New Jersey, mm-hmm. and it was like a stadium, you know, like Gillette, or it was amazing. And everybody's singing a song. And then you'd see one side of, you know, while people are waiting to go into the room, mm-hmm. they all start singing together. Mm-hmm. It's a unique
That's
experience.
So cool.
And it's all a very positive experience. But what a fun date.
Yeah.
You know? If you think you can sing, take your wife or your husband. Let them try out. Even if you don't, you got a hotel, you get a room, and you go out, you have a good time, you meet a lot of wonderful people.
Yeah.
And there are people in the hall going, la, 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 mm-hmm. la, 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 la.
Yeah. Our students have always come back saying it's a really good learning experience.
Sure.
They come from our school, which is small in comparison to the amount of people that go to those auditions and right. they feel a certain way about how they sing, and they go to these auditions and they learn that there are so many different types of singers out there, many different types of musicians out there, and they can learn so much just like from being surrounded by other musicians.
You can, and I think if anybody can draw from that is be yourself.
Yes,
don't
exactly.
Don't be somebody else.
Yeah.
You have a certain gift. Use it the way mm-hmm. you do it.
Yeah, you don't have to sound like anybody. You don't have to play like anybody.
No, because you'll get lost.
Yeah. You
know? But it's a fun experience. Mm-hmm. So, great. Sign up now.
Yes, you can register now. You can register online. Our website is nashuacms.org. You can send an email to info@nashuacms.org. Or you can call the school. We have a lot of wonderful people in the office who would love to chat. The number is 603-881-7030. And we're open, I think our office hours are 12 to 8, Monday through Thursday.
So not bad for being newly appointed the assistant director.
I worked really hard on that.
You got it all down.
Yeah.
So are there any, do you folks put on any concerts for the community? Other than, you got the
yeah.
drumming thing.
But. So we do a few. We have, we are part of the Nashua Holiday Stroll every year. So we have the Trash Talk that performs. We also mm-hmm. have some voice students that come and perform as well throughout the stroll. We do concerts during the summer in Greeley Park after kind of an end to some of our camps. Some of our music therapy groups also put on concerts that are open to the public at Greeley Park. We have one coming up in a couple weeks. And we also do recitals every term. So it's a place for our students to showcase what they've been working really hard on all term. And it's for all ages, so not just the little ones. We've been recently dedicating one day of the weekend to our adult students. Mm. So they're able to come and show what they do and not kind of feel strange being like the only adult in a concert full of 7-year-olds playing piano. Which are also delightful, but it's a nice opportunity for the adults to kind of showcase what they can do and be surrounded by their peers.
Great.
Yeah. Yeah.
I like the idea of the camps. I remember I used to go to Temple Street School when mm-hmm. it was a school. Now it's a senior home. And one day, Mrs. Goyette brought in somebody to showcase all the instruments. And I remember somebody playing the saxophone.
Mm.
And I went home and I said, Dad, I want to play the saxophone. And because he was a jazz musician,
mm-hmm.
And he got me a saxophone. But unless somebody had done that, I wouldn't have known.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
I wouldn't have taken up that opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it has to be presented to you.
Mm-hmm.
Do you go to the schools and as the school, are you invited by other elementary schools or middle schools to showcase some instruments?
Definitely. There are opportunities where due to the music outreach program at the school, we're able to showcase specific programs at the school. So we do like a mini trash talk that goes around mm-hmm. and shows what we do, kind of get the kids interested. We also do lessons on wheels. So we can take our lessons and bring them to your school if you're interested. We also do an open house every year, so people can come to the school and we do a little mini like instrument safari. We call it like an instrument petting zoo at the school.
That's
and,
a good idea.
Yeah, and so and anyone can touch any instrument and learn to play any instrument. We do little mini lessons so that kids can come and do like a very small version of what a normal lesson would be. So we have a few opportunities where we can go into schools and kind of demo what it's like. I remember those demos from when I was little too.
Yeah.
Yeah, they were very, very influential.
So you started off with piano, but now you play guitar.
Yes. So I started off with piano when I was very young and then I quit because it's really hard to be taught by your dad. and then I played flute for all of elementary school and high school, but I was always singing. Singing was like the thing I did the most. And then in college, I had to learn guitar because as a music therapy major, you have to be proficient in piano, guitar, and voice.
Why guitar?
I think it's just really mobile. It's a really easy instrument to travel with. Yeah. It's not as confining as a piano. So if I'm doing a group at a piano, I feel really stuck to it. But if I have a guitar, I can move around and I can kind of bring it to the client I'm working with instead of having them come to me. Mm. It also provides really wonderful vibration. I have a lot of students who will put their hands or their feet or even their chin on the guitar because that input is really important to them.
Yeah, well, that's interesting.
Yeah, good sensory feedback.
All right, so how do they get in touch with you again?
So our school is, the phone number is 603-881-7030. The email is info@nashuacms.org, and our website is nashuacms.org.
Are you on Facebook?
We are. We are Nashua Community Music School on Facebook. Oh my goodness. I can't believe I almost forgot that.
Are you on Twitter and Instagram?
I don't think we have a Twitter or an Instagram. Okay. That's one of the things I want to do as assistant director is get us on Instagram.
Instagram is a good one.
Yeah. Great. It's cool with the kids. The kids like Instagram.
Yeah. Yeah. It's cool now.
Yes, that's true.
And then there's a whole host of them. Anyway, Toria, thank you very much for coming on the show.
Thank you so much. It's so nice to be here.
And congratulations on your role.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
So, instruments, music, it's a wonderful language, it's a wonderful tool, it's just wonderful. And if you're never too old and you're never too young to learn, and if you want to take up an instrument and learn a little bit more about music, or if you want to donate an instrument, I bet you would take that, wouldn't
you? We're always accepting donations.
If you have an instrument that you'd like to donate, an instrument can save a life, in my humble opinion, it can save a life because it can get a child interested in something and develop and grow. It's a wonderful tool, and it's something that people can use to express themselves in so many ways and bless so many other people. So if you're interested, contact the school, get involved if you'd like. And until next week, thank you very much for watching Gate City Chronicles. We'll see you.
The preceding program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.